click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have got to know about how can we prepare that is emulsion and what were the properties of the emulsion, as well as we've also talked about that is a de-emulsification. And based on this all three we are going to talk about the classifications, that is the types of the emulsion, and that is we are going to talk about the difference between the oil in water emulsion as well as the water in oil emulsion. So what is the difference between these two? Let us talk about this. So the first difference is, that is, in this emulsion, the oil is the dispersed phase and the water is the dispersion medium, because as it itself suggests, that is oil in water. It means the oil will be the dispersed phase and the water will be the dispersing medium, and that is what the definition of oil in water emulsion is. And talking about the next one, that is water in oil emulsion. So in this emulsion, basically the water is the dispersed phase and the oil is the dispersed medium. So this was the first difference between these two, and we have studied in our previous lecture also the same thing, but there are also few differences between these two. And so that we are going to distinguish between these two, and let us talk about that also. So talking about the second difference, that is water is the continuous phase, where in the example of that is oil in water emulsion, and talking about the water in oil emulsion, in which basically oil is basically the continuous phase. So this is the second difference that we have got to know about. And now let us move on to the third point, and that is so suppose if water is added to this emulsion, and we know that the water is acting like a dispersed medium and a continuous phase, so therefore the water will get easily miscible in this kind of emulsion. So talking about water in oil emulsion, so in which basically if we add oil in that emulsion, so now the oil will be completely miscible in that kind of emulsion. So that we could also differentiate between that which one of the following emulsion is of which type. So that is what we can differentiate. So talking about this one, that is for that is oil in water. So even though if you are adding oil in this kind of emulsion, so oil will not get that is miscible, and in which basically the water will get miscible. But in this case, suppose if we add water, then in that kind of emulsion, water will not be miscible with that emulsion. So this is how we can differentiate also, and these are the two differences between these two emulsion. So now talking about the next property. So in oil in water emulsion, even though if we add a small amount of that is electrolyte, the conduction of the emulsion will increase. The reason behind that is because water is acting like a dispersed medium, and that's the reason that even though if we are adding electrolyte in it, so therefore obviously it will convert it into a that is a cation and anion whenever an electrolyte is been added in a dispersed medium, and in this case the dispersed medium is water. So therefore the conduction of this kind of emulsion will be increasing if we add electrolyte in it. So talking about that is the water in oil emulsion, and if we add a small amount of electrolyte, so in this case we could see that oil is acting like a dispersed medium. So even though if we are adding electrolyte in it, so the conduction will not increase. So therefore we could say that there is no effect in the conduction. So this happens, and by this also we could easily detect that which one of the emulsion is of which type. And yes, these are the two different properties that we have got to know also. So this is the difference that we have talked about. And now let us move on to the next point. And what is the next point? Let us talk about it. Basic metal sulfates, or we could say like alkali metal soaps, they act as emulsifier, and we have understood what is it, emulsifier also. So in basically in oil and water, the basic metal sulfates and alkali metal soaps, which are basically soluble, they act as emulsifier. While talking about the water in oil emulsion, in which basically the water in soluble soaps like soaps of Zn or soaps of aluminium and iron, they act like emulsifier, along with that of alkaline earth metals, they act as an emulsifier in that is water in oil emulsion. So this was the two difference between the two terms that we have talked about, or the classification of the emulsion. So that's it. So this is what I want to discuss about. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and you have got to know the difference between these two. So I hope you will share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.